So last time we were talking about how contraction mappings make it so that value iteration converges, you know, in the limit that we end up solving the Bellman equations. I'm not going to want to say too much more about value iteration, but on one slide, I want to at least summarize a couple interesting things that are worth knowing. All right, so here's the first one. If you think about Q T star, so that's the Q function that we get if we run value iteration for T star iterations.
Okay.
We know that it converges in the limit. We know that QT eventually goes to Q star. But here's kind of an interesting thing that we know about the finite horizon. So there is some T star less than infinity that's polynomial in the number of states, the number of actions, the magnitude of the rewards in the reward function, the number of bits of precision that are used to specify the transition probabilities, and 1 over 1 minus gamma. So that if we run value iteration for that many steps, the Q function that we get out is Q sub T star of SA. If we define a policy, pi SA, which is just the greedy policy with respect to that Q function, that policy is optimal. Okay. So what we're saying here is that we know that in the limit, if we run value iteration for an infinite number of steps, then the Q function that we get out at that point, the greedy policy with respect to that Q function is optimal. But what this is saying is that there is some time before infinity where we get a Q function that's close enough so that if you do the greedy policy with respect to it, it really is optimal, like all the way 100% optimal.
So what that really means is it's polynomial in the things you would expect to matter. And so that's saying that you can actually solve this in a reasonable amount of time.
Yeah.
I mean, anytime I see the word polynomial, I'm like, okay, what you're saying is this is reasonable.
Yeah. Now, the trick in this particular thing, the reason it's not just polynomial, is this 1 over 1 minus gamma. So as gamma gets close to 1, this blows up. And that's not polynomially bounded in, say, the number of bits that it takes to write down gamma. So it really is exponential in terms of the number of bits it takes to write down the whole problem. But even so, you know, if you take gamma to be some fixed constant, then 1 over 1 minus gamma might be really big, but it's some fixed constant, and we're polynomial in all the rest of this stuff. So what this really all boils down to is the idea that once you fix an MDP and the number of bits of precision that you're using to write it down, then there's going to be some optimal action, and there might be other actions that are tied for optimal in any given state, but the second best action is going to be some actual bounded amount away from optimal. So it can't get arbitrarily close to optimal. It's going to be some distance away. And what that gives us is that when we run value iteration enough, eventually the distance between the best action and the second best action gets bigger than that gap. And once it's bigger than that gap, then the greedy policy is going to be optimal. It's going to choose the actual optimal action in all states.
So VI converges, and it converges in a reasonable amount of time.
Well, it's not that it converges in a reasonable amount of time. The greedy policy with respect to value iteration converges in kind of a reasonable amount of time.
Okay, that's a much better way of saying it. Okay, I buy that.
This turns out to be a consequence of Cramer's rule, which we're not going to talk about, but this is why once we write down everything with polynomial precision, that we are guaranteed to get some fixed-size gap between the best and the second best.
It's always amazing to me how you manage to get Seinfeld into our conversations.
Cramer rules.
Ha ha ha.